Well, thank you very much. Now, I'd like to start by acknowledging the traditional owners of this land, the Gadigal people, and pay respect to their elders past and present, and to pay respect to elders everywhere today, especially the female elders amongst us in our society, in our community, as it is International Women's Day. And can I say how thrilled and delighted I am to be here to speak to you on this very auspicious occasion, speaking at International Women's Day to a group of young women of the future, young women, dynamic women leaders and achievers of the future. Now, I thought that I'd start with the context that Sarah actually was speaking to me about earlier before we walked in today. International Women's Day celebrations in the developed world always have to be seen very, very clearly in the context of the extraordinary disadvantage and very, very low personal, physical and economic security that a lot of women experience in the developing world. And the United Nations in Australia this year is concentrating particularly on Papua New Guinea. And I think as we reflect on the role of women in society in Australia, we need to remember that one of the UN programs, for example, that was rolled out in conjunction with the Department of Foreign Affairs and Trade was one where women working in the markets in Port Moresby were not safe enough to take their daily takings home with them. They were often bashed and robbed on the way home, so that the UN, together with the Department of Foreign Affairs, actually institutionalized a very small, low-tech but much safer banking system so they could just go and deposit their daily revenue in a bank account so that it had some security, so they couldn't be bashed up on the way home and have their takings stolen. We need to think about the important role that women need to play in ensuring that better security, safety and well-being of women right around the world.